Helen, this is gonna be a nightmare to edit. I feel bad.
Okay, can we get started?
Okay, but, calm down. Well,
I just got asked to take off my shoes, so we certainly can't get started until my shoes are not coming off.
Okay,
also I'm gonna ask you guys to like introduce yourself.
Great, okay.
Let's go, we came through.
Oh my god.
So, yeah, Harvard is the shortest people.
Take your
shoes
off.
I'm so sorry.
Hey, bro, you're bullying everyone except Seabell here.
But I never actually put my foot on the carpet.
I didn't see you.
I never actually put my foot on the carpet.
Okay. What's up, guys? So welcome to my first Q&A video. Today we're just going to be answering some questions about what it's like to be a Harvard student. And you guys introduce yourselves first. Say like your name, intended concentration.
We'll do this.
Yeah, I was going to say which way.
Okay, you first. Go.
Yep, I'm Nathan. I'm studying mechanical engineering.
Shit. I'm Cyril. I am not studying mechanical engineering. I'm studying applied math.
I'm Eli, same as Nathan, mechanical engineer.
Seabell, neuroscience or psychology.
Helen, neuroscience or psychology.
Liana, social studies or gov.
Okay, and we're all first years, by the way. All right, so I asked you guys questions on Instagram, and I'm just going to choose the ones that I think are good for the video. So first thing we have is... dining hall food review, please.
Like, let's just go in the order that we said our names.
It's a controversial topic. Sometimes it's good, but you can't get a consistent good meal there, which is why people complain.
Nah, like, I would, like, they make you, so if we did the math, right, and they make you pay, like, $12 a meal or something like that, I would rather eat a burrito from Felipe's every single time over this.
Nah, me too, me too.
Like, come on now. $12?
I mean, I think it's $30 a meal.
What? Yeah, okay, no, you got me messed up.
It's a big meal most of the time. It can be mediocre, but it's either on the bad end. The only good thing they sometimes do is dessert. But, like, that's pretty hard to get wrong because you can buy that from the store. But
that's true.
You know what? I appreciate the effort they put in. They have to work a lot of hours. And, like, it's really hard to, like, satisfy everybody's needs and...
Yeah, honestly, everyone hates too much. It's, like...
Not everybody hates on it.
I think everyone hates an appropriate
literally
amount.
Everyone hates really it.
It's just, it's easier to complain about these things because it's good to hate on an institution as, like, big and as... you know.
Well, okay. Facts, because they keep flexing their endowments. Like,
no,
you can't
true.
Be flexing
like,
their endowments.
Like, endowment can't get us good food. Like,
facts, respectfully.
Yeah.
I'm just grateful we have food.
No.
That's all.
I think that's good or bad food.
No, it's just food, you know.
Overall rating of food. One person at a time. Go. On a scale of 1 to 10. Go.
1, 5. 1, bro. 1. 6.
6.5.
6.
5.5.
Great.
Okay.
Next question.
All right, next. Why everyone's sick on campus, goddamn?
Okay, so I actually talked to a doctor about this. So I recently went to visit an ENT, and he said it's basically because everybody's wearing masks all the time.
No, I agree.
And they're... Okay, yeah. Can you let me... Okay. Okay.
Shit.
Basically, they're wearing masks all the time, and that causes everybody's immunity to go down, because typically your immune system can build more resistance to something it's exposed to a lot over a long period of time, and because we're always wearing masks, we're protected from that now. And so initially the problem was COVID. There were like a few hundred cases, but since that has been mitigated by, you know, just time overall and people being more careful because of that and the tests as well, people are actually getting what's called as a respiratory infection, and that's what's causing people to stay sick for a long time.
Yeah. Wait, Cyril, can you like sit in the proper position?
Bro,
my legs are in extreme pain.
Next one. This is a question from Umichan, okay?
Oh, fuck.
The one
Go ahead.
Who do you hate most at Harvard?
I'm not answering this
question.
I don't hate anyone.
I'm a pure.
Yeah,
Actually, you know what? I used to hate people, but now it's only love. It's only love.
I'm gonna plead the fifth on this one.
All right, next one. What is your favorite part of being a Harvard student / living in Boston, like Boston area?
The clout. I really like everything. Everything else is mid. It's just like,
what's,
you know,
the favorite part
I say
of being
go to
Harvard,
student? It's a W.
I know this is the most cliche answer, but it's the people.
Yeah.
Oh, that's true. That's also true.
Yeah. Everyone's so true.
I would say the journey that the space has allowed me to discover like new things about myself. And discover discover what my values are, you know, who I want to spend my time with, how to set boundaries, how to create enough rest time for myself, exercise, eat well, and take care of my mental, physical, and spiritual well-being.
I'm not making time for any of those things. Anyway.
Did you find any cute guys at Harvard?
Okay, yes. Listen up.
Just
because you're cute, that does not entitle you to having an ego.
That's not the question.
Yeah, Kat.
Okay, your answer is yes.
Do we want to
hurt?
Is there anything with them? No.
Yes.
Yeah.
Not worth doing that, ladies, okay? Just focus on yourself. Focus on getting that bag. Focus on getting those grades and having fun experiences with your friends and having a good group of a support system around you, okay?
No, there's W's here. You just gotta find them.
Okay.
Don't waste your time.
Or do.
Stay out of these streets.
Who hurts you?
Or live.
Isabel, are you okay?
That's a good question. What is the most challenging class you take at Harvard?
Xbox 20.
Okay, explain what that is.
Xbox 20 is an expository writing class. It's really not fun at all. Like, there's no redeeming qualities to it. I have to be honest. Like, I'm just a terrible writer also, so that could be a me problem, but the class is really hard. You have to take it, so it's not like you can't, like, there's no way of getting around it. So.
This is any engineer in a writing
class. I'm not gonna lie. I love my Xbox class.
That's because Cyril's in a good one, you're in a bad one.
Yeah, well,
there are different ones. Cyril's in a one about con artists, Eli's in.
I just gotta watch movies all day. It's kind of a W.
I'm a humanities person, so I really like my Xbox class. But that being said, like, they, at least from what I've heard, they structure the class, only one person gets an A. So, like, that makes it very hard.
Oh, shit.
Yeah.
You're like, I literally can't, like, my legs hurt so.
I sympathize with
because if I go like D's, it's like but then like if I go too low, then it's like
sit on the pillow.
Math 22, bro.
Math
21.
We're in math
21.
Good. Math 22 is harder.
Math 21
is easy.
Okay. No. All right. Great. All you established that there are hard classes.
How do you deal with mental health?
Yeah, I was gonna say, bro, I just live my life.
I don't know, I do face masks, I listen to a lot of like chilled out R&B music, I like to go on walks, I like to work out, I don't know, yeah, things like that.
Talking to your roommates, my roommates and I, whenever one of us is upset, we like sit on a common room floor for like 2 hours. We just discuss.
Yeah, I just like to hang out with my friends on the weekends.
Nice.
Yeah, I just listen to music, play music, watch a movie.
Mm-hmm. It's important to take some time off, like just to focus on yourself.
Yeah, like spend some alone time.
Yeah, alone time. Because you're around so many people all the time.
All the time.
It's good to just like be alone sometimes.
Yeah.
Yeah, I also do Q&As with randoms. Like, that's kind of the way I
stress. This is your recharge time.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Feels so rejuvenated.
Okay. Yeah. How difficult is the work?
It's harder than I thought it'd be,
honestly.
Yeah.
Like, I thought the hardest part of Harvard was getting in. Like, that's a stereotype. But it's not true at all.
No, once you get here, it's so much harder,
Also, like, I think part of it is also you're living by yourself for the first time for a lot of people here. And so that's also something new that you have to adjust to.
Sure. If I didn't make a conscious effort, I definitely think the workload would just eat up my social life.
Yeah.
Like, I have to make a conscious effort to, like, see people.
Yeah.
I think the hardest thing is just managing time. Like there's, like, social, there's sleep, academics, like, all these different, like, types of activities that you could
You'll never be bored. You never run out of things to do. There's always too much.
Yeah. So there's always
something to do.
Is Harvard really like Hogwarts?
Okay, yeah. Annenberg,
no,
yes.
No.
Annenberg, yes.
I will say
the houses, kind of.
The architecture is really like Hogwarts. Now, is it as magical and like mystical? I don't know.
It's not the closest really thing you can get to Hogwarts in the Muggle world.
That's cap. Yeah. You could definitely go to Oxford. It would be more like Harvard.
Just
go to anywhere in England instead and you'll be chill, you know?
Yeah. Because
then you have plus 5 points for accent, so.
Is dating interesting? Interesting as in non-existent? Yes.
Yikes.
Damn, bro. Like,
dating doesn't exist here.
Hookup culture is what the substitute for dating.
Yeah. I am happy that my head's out of frame for this.
If you're looking for anything serious in freshman year, Don't.
Just yeah, don't.
It'll also eat up way too much of your time and you won't be able to.
Just go to the grad important. School. Go to the grad school if you want to do something
oh
like that.
Oh my
okay?
god.
Hey, yo.
I don't think that's true.
I don't know about that one, but.
Hey, yo.
She's not wrong, but still, I don't know if that'll make the cut. Maybe it will. I don't know.
Not make the cut. Okay. Unknown facts about Harvard. Go.
I didn't really know much about the school like now, so I don't know.
Okay, wait, I know fact about Harvard.
Oh,
wait, hold on.
Can we just like make some shit up?
Okay, so the library is named after someone who died on the Titanic, and for a long time it was a requirement to actually pass the swimming test here because of that death. Every single night there's something called brain break, and it's from 9 to 11,
yeah,
and they serve snacks there. Mm. Another unknown fact about Harvard. Let's see.
Final clubs.
Oh, if you touch the foot of John Harvard, you get good luck.
Yeah facts. Yeah. Major.
Totally.
Major.
Yeah, makes it a lot easier to get into the school. So do that.
Yeah.
I think a lot of people don't know about the housing system.
Yeah. So basically, if you're a first year, a lot of first years are housed like in Harvard Yard, like we are in my room right now. But like some people, they're like in the inn, and that's basically like a hotel. They're in Prescott, just like basically apartments like off the street somewhere.
And there's Apley.
Oh, Apley.
So basically Apley is like this thing that's hidden away and was actually constructed for the aristocratic kids to avoid, you know, the common folk of Harvard. And so it houses 30 people. The staircase is marble. There are like these marble fixtures above the water fountains. The sinks are marble. And each room is as big as, like, each individual room is as big as some people's suites here.
Is that why Apley's so bougie?
Yeah.
Oh, wait, that makes so much sense.
It's like 30 people live in Apley.
Yeah. We have a friend who lives there, and we got to see, and I was just like, this is an injustice.
It's insane.
The fact that, you know, the housing system
is... It's like one suite per floor.
The housing system is a lottery here, or that's what they say.
Cyril, get your head in frame.
Bro, okay.
I feel his pain, bro.
So essentially, yeah, that's what it is.
Do you take Math 55?
No.
So if you guys don't know, what even is the name of Math 55? It's like some type of proof thing. I don't know.
It's like abstract, group like theory? Einstein group type.
It's literally the hardest math class here. And the first years who are in it are thriving because they're that good at math.
They're cracked.
Well, I have several friends who started taking it and then stopped.
We have some
Math 55 veterans.
The kids who are in Math 55 and dropped, most of them could do it. They just said they didn't want their whole life to be one class. Because, that's what it is.
Yeah.
It's like picking up two varsity sports, I heard. Many hours.
Eli, do you want to go into a Math 55 class one day and just be like, this is so easy? Or just like make slide comments about how easy it is?
Same thing like with Hum 10. Like, who's in Hum 10? Nobody. None of us, right?
What is Hum 10 even?
Humanities.
It's a full year class, you read a big ass novel every week. I wouldn't do that.
Watch your profanity.
Hypocrisy. Oh my god! Hypocrisy!
Please leave that in the video.
Yeah, that's true.
I remember when I was like asked to Chronicles. Clearly very smart. I know my vocabulary.
How many languages do you speak? 4-ish.
2. But like, let's not test the Spanish.
Okay. What is a typical day like? So there's no one typical day.
Yeah.
Like all of our schedules are very different every day.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Harvard is what you make of it.
Yeah.
It really is. There's so many people who don't take advantage of like...
Facts.
Everything that's available to us.
Yeah.
Facts. Like you could easily go through all four years here without, you know, meeting all the amazing people.
Or grinding. Like there are ways to finesse this place, but that's just like if you want to do that.
But I feel like it's kind of pointless to get into a place like this. I think a really useful thing to do is, you know, before the start of each semester or, you know, weekly check in with yourself and kind of like set goals or things that you want to try or do. It doesn't necessarily have to be like, I'm going to get a grade in this class or get an internship or whatever. Just like personal goals. Like I want to meet this many new people. I want to try something new here or whatever it is so that you can get the most fulfilling experience. And that's completely customizable for every single person. So, yeah.
All right. Final question, I think.
Oh, say less.
Any advice for prospective students?
You better work hard. Yo, work with my college consulting company.
Yeah!
You get the bag. It's a high price, but trust me, you're getting your money.
I tutor, so if you need help with anything, I tutor French, Mandarin, Spanish, English. I also give college prep. I help with essays as well as, you know, interview.
All right, as the only person who's not, like, financially, like, tied to this response, you're going to be fine no matter what school you go to. That's the most important thing. Like, the future of your life is not determined by where you go. It's by how you act, okay?
Facts.
That's the most important thing.
Okay, life is... what is this quote?
No, stop.
Life is 10% what happens to you, 90% what you choose to do.
What you make of it.
Come to college with, like, a strong sense of self. Like, be willing and open to change. With that being said, like, know what your values are, and you'll probably do well.
Mm-hmm. Also, just put yourself out there. Like,
absolutely.
Make friends. Like, don't be like hesitant to just go out there and do stuff.
Okay.
Also, wait. One thing I actually want to say, low key challenge yourself. Because kids get here and they're like, yo, I just care about getting an A. Mm-hmm. It's not really about that. Like, get the experiences, get the knowledge, because then you're just going to be levels above these other heads. You know what I mean? So just work hard. Mm-hmm. Just be great.
Yeah. Also, if you are a high school student looking to, like, get into a school like Harvard, I wouldn't recommend, like, obsessing over getting into, like, a particular school, because you never know, like, what the outcome will be like with your college decisions.
I got rejected from Yale, and I was rejected from Yale early decision. That hurt, but I took it in stride. I used the opportunity to, like, see my flaws and improve myself, and then I applied to Harvard out of spite for Yale. Like, that's why I'm here, okay?
I'm gonna say this. So a lot of times in life, we think that, oh, if I get this goal, if I get into this school, if I get this job, I make this much money, like, that's going to be the end all be all. I'm finally going to be happy, and I'm finally going to compensate for all the other insecurities I have. But once you get into a place like this, it feels great in the moment, but that is not what sustains our happiness. Mm-hmm. What sustains our happiness is just continually growing and making progress and surrounding ourselves with good energy. Yeah. It's not about an end goal. It's continually about becoming the best version of yourself and finding other people who help you enhance that and grow as a human being, not just as a student, not just as, you know, whatever you want to have a profession in. It's really just about personal growth. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
All right.
Word.
Thank you.
Respectfully.
Thank you guys for your answers. I think this concludes the video. Cyril, stay in the video. Stay in the frame.
All right,
so you already plugged your college consulting thing or whatever, and your tutoring thing. So if you guys want to, like, plug whatever,
fill out the Google form.
Where do they follow you?
My Instagram is @Liana_McGee, but my plug is for the Harvard Political Review, harvardpolitics.com.
Hey, Nathan, go.
I don't have a plug. Just good vibes.
Okay, great.
YouTube channel.
Yeah, I have a YouTube channel called Launch Window Research. You're probably not going to be interested in it. It's just
don't
about
say
investing
that.
In
no,
the space.
No,
people
might
be interested.
Yeah,
sell yourself.
No.
All right. Cyril, go. What is your thing specifically called?
It's called Ivy Dreamers. If you just leave a comment on whatever video this is, I'll find you respectfully. And also, give the Harvard Crocodiles a listen. We just dropped a new Christmas album that came out yesterday.
Hey.
It's pretty fire. So give us a listen.
Okay, my Instagram is cbell_fasquel. You can fill out Google form. That's in my bio. I also have a TikTok, cbell1823. You know, I drop funny videos, advice videos, just a stream of my consciousness.
Okay, Eli, go.
I got nothing really. My Instagram is @Eli. Wait, shit, what is it? ELIKIR7.
No, I know it's ELIKIR7.
Yeah, that's it.
Yeah.
That's about it.
All right, and for me, I would just want you guys to like and subscribe. And follow all of us on Insta. Yay. Okay.
Say less. Can I turn this off?
Yes, you can turn it off. Okay.